we're going to be talking about building custom interactive lessons in Nearpod. If really engaging students is your issue and you're looking for just getting that visibility of student thinking out there, I would recommend you check out Nearpod. What I'm going to focus on again is the internal lesson builder in Nearpod that you can access here where it says My Lessons and you have the Create drop-down menu. Now, I do want to point out if you're relatively new to Nearpod that Nearpod does also have a library of content. I would highly suggest that you check it out. There's all kinds of great content integrations in Nearpod that are definitely worth looking at. To build a lesson, what we're going to do here is go to the Create button, and we're going to go here to Lessons. Now, I forgot to mention this in the beginning, that what we're going to do is I'm basically going to show all the different features very quickly that you can use. So there's content features, and there's going to be activities features. What I'm also going to do is essentially build a whole lesson. I'll build a lesson in Nearpod following the 5 E's. What you're going to do when you're in this lesson builder is go here to add slide. Now you'll notice you can bring some files in. We are going to do that a little bit later, but I just want to start here with adding slides. So essentially what you can do here is build a slide deck out in the same way you would with PowerPoint, in the same way that you would with Google Slides, but you can effectively make almost every single slide in here interactive. The first one here is the slide option. So slide option is basically like building a Google slide here. So you can create your own opening to a lesson. You can also change the layout. So here, if you wanted, you could make this say 2 element right here. And then you can also bring in some media over here on the other side. So here you could do something like fun, see what they have for a GIF here. Just bring in something silly to start. Just build my own little custom thing here. And then I can also change the way that it would look right there. I'm just gonna go through and start mixing some of these content and activity slides. Now we can bring in an activity. So let's say, for example, that we're gonna teach something like the respiratory system. So I might give students instructions to draw what you think the respiratory system looks like. Now you can also add timers to these. So you can go up here to the timer button and you can say that they have 2 minutes, for example, to do this drawing. Now students would have some drawing tools that they could use in order to draw the respiratory system. So you'll see they have drawing tools. There's a highlighter tool that can add some text, an image, things like that. Now bring in some content, right? So you'll notice that I'm very loosely here following the 5 E's. I'll talk more explicitly about that when I actually build an actual lesson, not this kind of fake lesson here. I'm not going to show every single one. There are a few that I really like here. One absolutely is the video tool. This is their newest tool. The video tool is essentially an integrated ed puzzle where you can add interactive questions to videos. Web content can be good if you want to have students be able to open up a separate web page. I like Nearpod 3D, so I'm going to show you that right now. Add a 3D image of the respiratory system. So I'll click on it, click done, and then it's going to bring in an image that students will be able to manipulate, get closer to, zoom in on, move around as they would like. So it's just a neat tool that's there for you if you are really trying to build your students' conceptual understanding. FET simulation tool. So this is particularly helpful for math science. It's actually only really math science content. Let's say you did need to teach students how to do fractions and you were practicing fraction operations. What you can do is bring one of these activities in and it essentially becomes an interactive activity that students can work on in class. So this is a series of different levels. So we'll just go here to level 1. And essentially this is building students' conceptual understanding, right? So there's no words here describing what to do. You could of course give instructions, or part of the point of this is to have students puzzle through this and figure this out. Virtual field trips, I also really like. These are going to essentially generate a 360-degree image You don't have to have virtual reality headsets to use these. You could bring in that 360-degree image, and then they'll be able to essentially drag it around. They can look at that place. The Collaborate board is basically, if the video is the Edpuzzle integration, the Collaborate board is the Padlet tool that they've integrated into Nearpod. Students can post responses, so they could post observations. You can write a description down below. So the BBC video content tool is, it's okay. I liked it before they brought in the interactive video tool. It's basically just going to bring in some videos from BBC that are not interactive. So not as effective anymore. I wouldn't, this one, it's fine, but not anything particularly special. The Sway integration is kind of cool. These are basically just going to be digital pamphlets of information. It's going to have some images. It's going to have some key ideas about this concept. So it's just providing some visual reinforcement, some key pieces of information about that concept. Slideshow is just going to be a series of pictures. That's great. I think totally use them, but it's just a series of pictures. Audio is going to allow you to bring in an audio file. PDF viewer will allow you to upload a PDF. A better way of being able to bring in PDFs so that you can actually make them interactive is by using the drawing tool. What we'll say is annotate. Then what you can do is go to upload background image. Now they can also draw over the text. So they can use a highlight tool. They can annotate for unknown words. Matching pairs is also a lesson or also an activities tool that can be useful. So here, what you could do is, let's say you were teaching some vocabulary and you were teaching agriculture. Then what you could do is search for a picture of agriculture, farming, pull that in, and that's going to create a pair. When I click preview, what a student will do, and you can imagine, let's say that we've made a lot of these, then students would match those around the Flipgrid integration. You can also have students respond via video in Flipgrid and then be able to respond to each other with this Flipgrid integration. You would have to still make the lesson here in Flipgrid. Then you'd have to get these links and you'd have to put them in. You'll see that it's just going to essentially take students to the Nearpod interface when they get to that slide. What I want to show right now is how to actually build a logical lesson. But what I'm going to do right now is build a ELA lesson around the skill of identifying character traits. And we're going to have students identify character traits based on direct characterization and indirect characterization. So we're going to have an engage portion. We're going to have students explore, explain, elaborate, and then there's going to be an evaluation piece at the end. So we're going to do ELA lesson here. I'll bring in something. I like the GIF, so I'll bring that in. We can change the style there. What we're going to do to start is bring in a Collaborate board. I'm going to ask them, what are some characteristics of a person you admire, to actually start to get students to norm and learn about characterization. I'm going to go here to add slide. I'm going to bring in a video. They have added a ton of content, pre-made content with pre-made questions. Right now, this video doesn't really have questions that are targeted in the way that I want them to be targeted, because they're not asking students about direct and indirect characterization yet. So what I would do is I would find those places in the video where it talks about the skill that I'm trying to apply. So right here, she's talking about direct characterization, and then you can add an activity. So now we're talking about indirect characterization. So I could add another interactive question about that. I'm going to bring in a fill in the blank activity here. The idea here is that I am identifying key points from that video that I just played that I want to review as a check for understanding, to see whether or not students are understanding this key idea. Click on the word. So I know that I want students to be able to identify indirect, for example. And let's say I also want students to be able to identify this word trait. We would get a sense of whether or not they were understanding it. We're going to go to draw it. I want students to identify one example of direct characterization. Tell students that we have 5 minutes, for example. I'm going to add the open-ended question here. I'll ask students to write a 1 to 2 paragraph story about a person they admire. Now you can add media, video, instructions here. Then I'm going to close this lesson out with an evaluation. Now you could do the regular quiz tool for an evaluation, which is going to be kind of regular old quiz, which is fine. I would recommend you do Time to Climb instead. It's a competition. So here you can make your own questions. I'm going to show you how you can run this live with students. So we'll go here to save and exit. This is our characterization lesson. And you could run this asynchronously. I really like Nearpod though for live lessons. So you're in Google Meet, you're in Zoom, you have students open up the link that you're going to share with them and you have them pull that over to half their screen. And then on the other half of the screen, you can still have them watching your live feed through Zoom, through Google Meet. You can choose whether or not you want to share your screen with them. Set this up by going here to live participation. You will get some different options for how you could share it. You can, very easy way is to just grab the link here. This is one way to do it. Students can just go and then they can enter the code and then they're going to enter their name and you're going to start to see the roster of students as they're coming through. And I'm in full control, right, as the teacher. So as I'm advancing through the slides, once the interactive features come up, then I'll have some different options. So for this one, for example, I can approve or choose whether or not I want to approve student answers as they're coming in. Now, the video feature, I would recommend that you set this up so that it's on this device only. So what that's going to do is make you in control of the pace of the video. And when they get to that question, okay, it's going to pop up. Now we're going to have them do some basic fill in the blank. So now they're going to drag. So they'll click those and what they can do is bring them in. It'll tell the student 4 out of 4. I will also be able to see who got what and what their score was as they're coming through. Now, what students are going to do is draw it. So when I click start activity, now students are applying this skill. And you'll notice here that I, as the teacher, I'm basically able to see this entire workspace so I can see what students are doing. And then you can also share these just like I shared the other answers. You can share these back with the class. All right, now we're going to have students apply the knowledge in a deeper way. So this is where they're going to write. They'll click submit. I'll start to see their answers coming through. This last piece is that evaluate piece where we're going to play a gamified quiz. It's just much more fun than doing a regular old bland quiz to have a little game like this. So recommend that you check this out. It doesn't have to be high stakes. It can just be a way to see what students know as an informal formative assessment at the end.